Welcome in this video. I am Dr. Vinita Bhadauria, Associate Professor of English in Government College, Behror. This video is beneficial for BA Part 2 students. This belongs to their paper first. This is the introductory video on the Indian poet Arun Kolhatkar. Full name of Arun Kolhatkar was Arun Balkrishna Kolhatkar. He was an Indian poet who was writing in English as well as his native language Marathi. He was born in Kolhapur on 1st November 1932 in Maharashtra, where his father Tatya Kolhatkar was an officer in the education department. He lived in a traditional patriarchal Hindu extended family along with his uncle's family. He has described their 9-room house as a house of cards, 5 in a row on the ground, topped by the 3 on the first and 1 on the second floor. He attended Rajaram High School in Kolhapur, where Marathi was the medium of instruction. He was graduated in 1949 and enrolled in a college of arts, the J.J. School of Art and the James T. Jijibai School of Arts. He was graduating in 1957 and winning many awards as a graphic designer. He worked as an art director and graphic designer in many reputed advertising agencies like Lintas. His poems found humor in many everyday matters. His poetry had an influence on modern Marathi poets. His first book of English poetry was Jazuri. Kolhatkar was among a group of post-independence bilingual poets who fused the direction and diction of their mother tongue along with international styles to break new ground in their poetic tradition. He was an Indian poet who was writing in English as well as his native language Marathi. Kolhatkar is the only Indian poet other than Kabir to be featured on the World Classics titles of New York Review of Books. Jazuri was his first collection of English poetry. He won the Commonwealth Poetry Prize in 1977 for Jazuri. He has written Jazuri in 1976. It is a collection of 31 poems about a visit to a religious shrine of the same name, Jazuri, in Maharashtra. His Marathi poems of the 1950s and 60s are written in the Bombay argot of the migrant working classes and the underworld, part Hindi, part Marathi. His Marathi verse collection Bhiski Vahi won a Sahitya Academy Award in 2005. His collected poems in English, edited by Arvind Krishna Malhotra, was published posthumously in Britain by Bloodex Books in 2010. He won the Kusum Agraj Purushkar given by the Marathwada Sahitya Parishad in 1991. He was awarded by the Bahinabai Purushkar in 1995 by Bahinabai Pratishthan. His major collection of poetry are Jazuri, Kala Ghoda and Sarp Satra, which is translation of his Marathi collection of poetry, Bhiski Vahi. Bhiski Vahi is Sarp Satra in English by similar, it is a typical Kolhatkar's narrative poem like Drone, mixing myth, allegory and contemporary history. Although Kolhatkar was never famous as a social commentator, his narrative poems tend to be just. Many poems in Bhiski Vahi contain plenty of comments on the contemporary history. However, these are not a politician's comments but a poet's, and hence he avoids the typical Dalit leftist feminist rhetoric. What is significant here is the shift in the poet's attitude and technique. While Jazuri which is the most famous collection of poems, was about the agonized relationship of a modern sensitive individual with the indigenous culture. Jajuri was published in 1976. His small poems are pensive and more realistic in nature. The poem Jajuri has been highly acclaimed by critics. Some of Kolhatkar's admirers keep it at par with T.S. Eliot's The Wasteland. Jajuri is a pilgrim center to the southeast of Pune, and Khandoba is the deity worshipped there. Chaitanya visited this place in early 16th century. Kolhatkar describes his visit to Jajuri, reaching it by bus and returning by train. During the interval, Kolhatkar goes round, sees god, priests, men, animals and rodents. The poem Jajuri is a very faithful record of his impressions. There are 38 lyrics, but the poet is an uneasy, neutral, worrisome, and every other stone is a god for his defective. There are beggars and the hill range dominate the prospect. There is much stirring in the peevish gutter of the just below the surface consciousness, and one receives no light, no exhilarating surprise or surmise. Kolhatkar has a real mastery of the language, and there is the stir of uneasy life in many of the pieces. The impression left by the temple on the poet has been described along with the scene of the railway station. He describes both the places with realistic smiles. Both places suffer from old traditions and superstitions. Both the places after isolation, deadly silence and disease. Towards the end of the poems, there is one lyric which presents great contrast between Jajuri and the railway station. The poet expresses a satire and lack of reverence. There are very rare moments of pathos, only when a begging woman encounters a newly married bride. Kala Ghoda is another collection of poems, are about the dark underside of Mumbai's underbelly. The bewildering heterogeneous megapolis is envisioned in various oblique and whimsical perspectives of an underdog. Kala Ghoda is also a place poem exploring the myth, history, geography and ethos of the place in a typical Kolhatkar's style. He has also written in Marathi language. His early Marathi poetry is far from audacious and takes greater liberties with language. However, in his later Marathi poetry, the poetic language is more accessible and less radical compared to the earlier works. His later works, Chirmiri, Bijkiwahi, and Drone, are less introverted and less nightmarish. They show a greater social awareness and his satire becomes more direct. He is a bilingual poet because he was writing in English and Marathi, in both languages, an anthologist. Vilas Sarang assigns great importance to Kolhatkar's contribution to Marathi poetry, pointing to Chirmiri and in particular as a work that must give inspiration and direction to all future Marathi poets. He belongs to the postmodern literary movement of India. He was died on 25th September 2004 in Pune, Maharashtra, at the age of 71. There are two poems prescribed in your course, that is The Bus and An Old Woman, which I will discuss in the next video. In this video, I had already discussed about all the collections of the Arun Kolhatkar and his life. Thank you very much.